underneath the fuse box in the engine compartment. This is the driver's side going over towards the passenger side. This first 40 amp fuse right here, this one is the secondary air pump 40 amp fuse. I already tested that and that's good, so we're going to move on to the next thing. All right, ladies and gentlemen, 2006 and up ML350. I've taken out the secondary air pump, I've checked the fuse, and the fuse is good. I'll show you guys where the fuse is in a minute. But I've taken the pump out because I keep getting a secondary air pump failure. And so I want to check this pump to see if it's good. And it's a 30 amp fuse, 12 volts. And here's the fitting right here. It has a little minus for negative side and a plus side for the plus side pins. So I've wired up. Wired up a wire that I'm going to use to test this, and the wire is just basically going to my jump point and then to ground the engine block, and when I hook this up to the plus side and the negative side, if the pump is good, it will start to spin. If it's not good, it won't get any response. Let's see. All right, so the pump is good. Pump is good. Fuse is good. Maybe the electrical connection leading to the pump is bad or has a short. I recently did a lot of work on this engine. I replaced the air intake manifold, and maybe that connection right here, maybe that has a short or isn't connected properly. So I'm going to go hunt that down. All right, ladies and gentlemen, in troubleshooting this secondary air pump, I said, let me take a look at these hoses that run right underneath it. And in doing so, this hose right here that runs right underneath this secondary air pump, I took off the secondary air pump when I was doing the mass airflow sensor and the air intake replacement. And look at this hose right here. When I put it back together, look at this. It's been squished. It's been squashed. It's been squished. It's been shut off, and that's been giving me the secondary air pump failure. So I went ahead and I cut the damaged section out, and I'm going to replace it with the proper hose when I have a chance to go to the dealership and buy one. They sell it by the foot. But until then, I want my check engine light to go off. So I'm going to put a jumper tube between these two. Okay? And basically, I'm going to do one of these. It's just going to be... basically going to just take some of this hose. I clipped it off from here. This is just an emergency job, folks. It's not the end job. And I'm going to jump it like this. Okay. It's not a very high PSI line. I wish I had more of this, but I don't. And I'm going to reconnect it to the valve, and this piece will go into the air intake. And this is just an emergency fix, like I said.